The following is paid for by the Office of the Leader of the Opposition.
My fellow Jamaicans, I'm addressing you this evening at a very perilous and frightening time for our nation. It is clear that our healthcare system has reached a breaking point. The COVID-19 pandemic has overwhelmed the system and caused a deep crisis of death and despair in our society. The more contagious and deadly Delta variant has caused a rapid increase in COVID-19 cases to levels never seen before in Jamaica. Over the past 3 days, we recorded 2,397 new cases, the positivity rate averaging about 50% with 35 deaths, and we've been regularly recording double-digit deaths for several days now. Those needing critical and intensive care have risen exponentially in recent weeks. Our healthcare workers are crying out for help. Our hospitals are overrun and under-resourced. We have seen photographs of patients lying on mattresses on the floors of hospitals. We are told that the manual bag valve masks have had to be used by medical staff for prolonged periods to enable patients to breathe where oxygen has run out. Many have suffered and some have died in these dire conditions. How did we get here? Where was the planning by the government to ensure an adequate supply of oxygen? In July, the Prime Minister told Parliament that arrangements were in place. That was clearly not so. The need for a much larger than normal supply of oxygen was entirely predictable once the government decided to loosen the restrictions in July. We knew that Jamaica has the lowest vaccination rate in the English-speaking Caribbean. We knew that the Delta variant was running rampant across the world. We knew that our borders have been open to visitors and the quarantine rules have not been effectively enforced. Proper arrangements should have been put in place to ensure an adequate supply of oxygen in the event of a runaway spike of COVID cases, which was a clear and present danger to our people. The failure to do so was a terrible dereliction of duty on the part of the government. If we fail to act now, we risk somber and terrifying days ahead. More than ever, we must be vigilant to stop the spread of this virus. Please, where possible, stay at home. Avoid talking up in each other's faces. Wear a mask covering your nose and your mouth and wash hands when you've been around other people. And most of all, please, take the first opportunity you get to become vaccinated. Vaccination is the best tool we have at our disposal to prevent hospitalization and death from COVID-19. Vaccination also puts a brake on the evolution of variants like Delta, now ravaging the world, including here. So, once again, all adult Jamaicans, all students of 12 years and upwards, please get vaccinated. Every Jamaican bears the burden of personal responsibility. Our choices matter in these perilous times, and I urge each and every one of us to follow information from trusted and reputable sources only. Please don't be misled by conspiracy theories and other misinformation. It is deadly. The opposition has on several occasions called for a variety of measures to be taken to protect the healthcare system, our healthcare workers, and the Jamaican people. The opposition stands ready to support the implementation of life-saving strategies and to place our country on a path to recovery. Indeed, I have written to the Prime Minister, calling on him to convene a summit to identify workable responses to the extremely desperate situation now facing our country, in a demonstration of a common fixity of purpose and national unity. I again reaffirm our commitment to working with the government to implement all necessary measures to help us secure a safe and stable future for Jamaica. Here are some suggestions that we are putting forward, which we believe will help to manage our way through this terrible crisis better. A high-level public-private sector committee should be tasked with the governance of the procurement of oxygen supplies and the logistics of oxygen delivery, with a clear mandate to plan ahead to ensure that we never run short of oxygen in our hospitals. Oxygen generators should be brought into Jamaica on an emergency basis to avoid shortages of this critical life sustainer in the fight of what is really a respiratory disease, COVID-19. Oxygen generators will reduce the reliance on bulk oxygen and cylinders, which are now supplied by only one local supplier. Equipment that can test for variants must be prioritized for purchase and deployment. It is just taking too long to get test results from samples that have to be sent overseas. Our healthcare workers are the most at risk, and the nation is depending on them to care for our citizens who fall sick. We are recommending that each parish has a dedicated healthcare staff facility to ensure that they are looked after well and promptly if they fall ill while serving on the front lines of this pandemic. Those vaccines which require less infrastructure for storage should be made available to private medical facilities to vaccinate their patients with counseling from their trusted doctors and pharmacists. This will assist Jamaica to get on track towards achieving a higher level of vaccination. There are very real challenges in many vulnerable persons getting vaccinated as a result of transportation costs and rural logistics. Vaccination blitz sites are out of reach for many ordinary Jamaicans. We again call for more community facilities to be used as vaccination centres, supplemented by deploying mobile units to visit these communities and increase the vaccine uptake. The efforts to vaccinate the too often overlooked community of persons with disabilities has been inadequate. Mobile units should be used for the purpose of taking vaccines to